Even as the Prime Minister today announced the first real easing of restrictions imposed in the wake of the health crisis...
Well, good afternoon, everyone.
..news that Virgin Australia had become a spectacular victim of the economic crisis was ricocheting around the country. Confirmation that Virgin was being placed in voluntary administration was hardly unexpected. Its public pleading for assistance from government, or anyone else for that matter, since aviation was effectively closed down last month, has been a daily feature of the news. The initial prognosis from administrators today was pretty upbeat in the circumstances.
There is no plans to make any redundancies. Wages will continue to be paid.
But the spectre of what would be the biggest aviation collapse in Australia's history, if it eventuated, came one step closer on a day of otherwise sobering economic news.
But over the first half of 2020, we are likely to experience the biggest contraction in national output and national income that we've witnessed since the 1930s.
All this grim news forms an integral part of the story of how governments now deal with the future of Virgin Australia. The political risk here is that Virgin becomes the go-to image of the coronavirus slump, not just of its economic cost, but the competence of the government in dealing with it.
The government says that they want a market-based solution, but it is government policy, and it's good policy, to protect Australians' health, which has shut down this market. There is no market here today.
The Morrison government in Canberra has been playing hardball, determined not to open the door to specific corporate bailouts, insisting that the market can find a solution, and being determined not to simply hand over money to foreign shareholders.
I'm encouraged by the fact that there are already 10 parties that have expressed interest in working with the administrator regarding Virgin's future.
The government's hard line is one of the reasons the Virgin board moved to call in the administrators. It represents not just an ideological position, but a tough assessment about what is going to happen in the economy for some years to come, with international travel restricted and a travelling public constrained by unemployment and lost income.
People will be looking at coming in, looking at the profitable sections, the profitable routes potentially. They won't be interested in flying as I've flown on Virgin into your Gladstones or into Townsville or into Mackay. They'll be interested in cherry picking.
This now looks like dangerous territory for the government. With workers reassured they will not lose their jobs, the issue will be just how competitive Virgin will be in future, particularly on those non-trunk routes into regional areas in the Coalition's heartland, and the heartland of tourism, where it has made such a competitive difference.
Hi, I'm Lee Sales. Thanks for watching this story. If you'd like to watch more of 7:30's stories, they are on the left of your screen. And tap on the button below to subscribe and get the latest from ABC News.